Welcome to Jurassic Park. What's up everybody, it's What Jim. In today's video, let's go ahead and rank all the Jurassic films, so Jurassic Park, all the way to Jurassic World Dominion. And this is my own opinion on these films, and you can let me know yours in the comment section below. But I decided to make this video no spoilers, just in case that there's a specific Jurassic film in the franchise that you have not seen. There's a total 6 to rank, so we'll get to it with my number 6. All the way to my favourite Jurassic film in this franchise. But this is also going to include a quick review of Jurassic World Dominion, which is the latest Jurassic film. And probably the last one as well, because it's meant to be the conclusion to this franchise. That's been lasting since the 1990s. So, yeah, when we get to Jurassic World Dominion, I will be doing a quick review for it. The reason why is because this was originally just going to be a review of Jurassic World Dominion, and I was going to rank the films quickly afterwards. But I thought the film's already been out over a month, I'm a bit late on the party for that one. So I will do a review for it, but it'll be a quick review. And I just thought it'd be just a more fun video to watch and more fun video to make if the main part of it was to rank the Jurassic films and then do a quick review when we get to Jurassic World Dominion. So hopefully that makes sense, and we'll get to it with my least favourite Jurassic film. So my least favourite film out of the Jurassic franchise is Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, which came out in 2018, and I would give it a 6 out of 10. I just think it's an okay Jurassic film, in my opinion. I just feel like the writing for this film is all over the place, and there's quite a few decisions made in this film that I feel like are very, very questionable. I don't know why they went that way for a lot of the decisions. But I want to say that maybe the last 20 minutes of this film, I think, is easily the best part of the film. I think that the way that this film ends definitely does end in a satisfying conclusion to me. But for the rest of it, I just think it's just okay to mediocre, in my opinion. When I first saw it in the cinema, I didn't think it was a great Jurassic film. I thought it was quite a good one. But then when I rewatched it, I could just see more and more problems. And I think it's going to be one of those type of films that the more I see it, the less I like it. And I just feel like, to me, it's the least memorable out of all the Jurassic films as well. And I don't know, I just feel like the writing is all over the place. There's quite a lot of questionable decisions. And it's just my least favourite of the Jurassic films for me. And my 5th favourite Jurassic film is Jurassic Park 3 from 2001. And I would give that one a 6.5. out of 10, I would think it's slightly better than Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. The reason why I prefer this to this one, I just think the action's a bit better, and plus it's got my favourite character from the Jurassic franchise. He's played by Sam Neill, and that's Dr. Alan Grant. He's my favourite character by far in this series, and he was just really, really great. I definitely would say that there were a few scenes that I did find quite emotional, but in my opinion, the third act for this film, it just felt too rushed, and the film just ended way too quickly. So I feel like, for me, the film just ended on a sour note. And I just feel like with this one, I just don't think the CGI has aged particularly well, in my opinion. It's not with the dinosaurs, because I think for most of the time it's using practical effects, but there is a bit of CGI in the film that I think it's not aged particularly well, in my opinion. But I still do think this film has got definitely it's enjoyable moments, but overall, I don't think it's a good film, but I do feel like it is much better than Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, in my opinion. So my 4th favourite is The Lost World Jurassic Park, which came out in 1997, and I think this is a good Jurassic film. And now we're now going to the ones that I quite like quite a bit, and I would give this one a 7 out of 10. I think it's great to have Ian Malcolm being the main character. Of course, he's played by Jeff Goldblum, and I think he just does a really, really great job as that character. I think it's one of his best acting performances playing Ian Malcolm, and I think this is his best time playing him, in my opinion. And I really, really like this film. But the reason why I prefer the other ones, I think it's just because it's not one I particularly rewatch a lot, and I feel like the ending could have been slightly better. But it is just quite a fun Jurassic film, but it's just not a great film for me. I also find the pacing for this film, it can be a bit off as well, but I've only seen Jurassic Park 3 and Lost World Jurassic Park only once, so my opinion on those two films could definitely change. But at the moment, this is where it stands. Jurassic World, or sorry, The Lost World, Jurassic Park is my number four for ranking the Jurassic films. And my number three is Jurassic World Dominion, which of course came out this year in 2022. And I would also give this one a 7 out of 10. But when I first saw the film, I gave it a 7.5 out of 10. I feel like there's a couple of plot lines in this film that I feel like, why did it really have to go to this direction? But of course, it was amazing to see some of the older Jurassic characters back into this one. I feel like they could have maybe been written slightly better. Their roles could have been a bit better in this film, and how they met could have been done a bit better. But it's just really, really great to see those characters. And there were definitely some scenes in this film that I did think was very, very intense. But now we'll go through it doing a quick review for this. So for this film, I think it was fun and enjoyable for quite a bit of it. I also thought that the story and the characters, Woods was done quite good. So were the relationships. And I thought the acting was done quite well here. And I thought the action, that was really, really fun. The music and score, I mean, for all these films, it's one of the best scores I've ever heard. It's just done a really, really marvellous job with all of these films, definitely. And I think the sound design was done very, very well here. And I thought the CGI was good for most of it. I feel like there was some of it that could have been done a bit better. I also thought that the visuals were very, very good to look at. And I thought that the humour, a lot of the time it did feel forced, but there was quite a bit of humour that did work for me. And there were a couple of scenes that I did find quite emotional towards the end of the film. For the bad for this film, I feel like there's at least one too many plot lines. And I thought the dinosaurs aren't used enough in this film, considering it's a film about dinosaurs. And I thought the villain was nothing special. I feel like in all the Jurassic films, the villains haven't been a standout for me. But this one, it was just nothing really memorable. It was one of these favourite Jurassic villains we've had. And I thought there were too much intense scenes and action in the second half of the film. I soon just thought there wasn't going to be any more intense scenes. There was another one, and an action scene. I just felt like it got a bit too much in the second half for me. And also, I think that Alan Grant and some of the other, older returning characters, I thought could have been used a bit better in this film. And I thought there were too many locations. I think there were just too many places they were going to. It was cool to see them going in that direction, because we've not seen this many locations in one of their films before. But I felt like maybe it went to too many locations. But I would recommend this film to people who like the Jurassic Park and Jurassic World films. And like I said at the beginning of talk about Jurassic World Dominion, I'd give it a 7 out of 10. And now we'll get to it with my second favourite Jurassic World film, which is Jurassic World from 2015. And I'd give that one 8.5 out of 10. Now, when I first saw this film, I thought it was absolutely amazing. And it was one of my favourite films of all time when I first saw it. And just to me, I feel like when I rewatch it, it's not as amazing as I thought it was, but I still feel like this is just a really, really great just film to watch. And it's just a great film to have food while you're watching, and just have a really, really enjoyable time. I thought the action was done very, very well. So is the characters, and it's great to see these new characters. Well, they were new for the time that this film came out. And it was just a really, really enjoyable film. I've not really got a huge amount to say about it, but it's just, I feel like it doesn't make as many mistakes as those other Jurassic films I previously mentioned. There were also a couple of scenes that did get to me, and I did really, really like Owen and Claire's relationship. I've always liked the relationships in all these films. Wasn't the biggest fan of it in Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, and Jurassic World Dominion, I thought that was done very, very well for it. If I had to describe this film in one word, it probably would just be enjoyable, because I felt like this film was enjoyable for pretty much all of it. I do think this is a really, really great blockbuster. Of course, my favourite is the classic, the original, from 1993, and I would rate it a 9.5 out of 10. One of my favourite films ever made, and that is Jurassic Park. There's so many amazing quotes from it, so many amazing moments and lines. The humour is just perfect here. The writing is perfect. I do feel like the first half an hour to 40 minutes is quite slow, but you learn about the whole this whole park, and you grow to really, really care about it. I feel like the park's almost like a character in of itself, and the dinosaurs are used perfectly here. The T-Rex is just as menacing as ever, and it's just really, really great that we're using practical effects. You weren't using CGI like what they were doing with the Jurassic World films. Alan Grant is also amazing here. This is by far the best outing for that character, and the relationships and all the character dynamics just work really, really well, and it's really, really intense. It's like a thriller, and it feels more like a thriller than all the other Jurassic films combined, in my opinion. It's just a near perfect film. I feel like if the pacing could have been slightly better for the beginning of the film, this would be a 10 out of 10, and it would be my top 5 films ever made. And when I first saw this film, for the first hour, I didn't really like this film very much, but then the second half is one of my favourite second halves of any film. It really, really is. It's perfect. That second half is perfect. And I just kind of want to watch Jurassic Park again, because I feel like I didn't give it justice the first time I saw it. I've seen it a couple of times since, but I don't think I've seen it all the way through. I've only seen it all the way through once. And like I said, I wasn't the biggest fan of it then, but all the other times I've seen it, I've absolutely loved this film. And it's, like I said, up there as one of my favourite films of all time. Probably not in my top 10, but very, very close to being. Anyway, that's it. I've ranked all of the Jurassic films, and hopefully you've enjoyed watching my thoughts on all of these, and hearing my thoughts on all of these. And you can let me know your ranking of these Jurassic films in the comment section below. But of course, no spoilers, in case there's a particular Jurassic film somebody's not seen when they're commenting or reading the comments for this video. That's what we're gonna say here. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe and comment, and I really, really appreciate each and every one of you who do subscribe and watch any of my videos. It really, really does mean a lot to me, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care, stay safe, peace out, and ciao. This is how you say ciao as a T-Rex.